What are NAD plus and NADP plus? Well, NAD plus is an acronym or an abbreviation for nicotinamide, adenine, dinucleotide. Nicotinamide is the N, adenine for the A, dinucleotide for the D. And NADP plus is nicotinamide, adenine, dinucleotide, phosphate. Now the bad news here is that you have to remember the proper names of these chemicals because they are actually mentioned in the syllabus and could appear on the exam paper. Now another notion to understand is that these are two complicated chemicals that are low in energy. Now, what is the role or the job of NAD plus or NADP plus? Well, these two chemicals are able to accept two high energy electrons, two high energy particles that are negatively charged, and a hydrogen ion, a H plus or a proton. And when they break down, the reverse happens. They're able to release two electrons and a hydrogen ion. So in a nutshell, according to the syllabus, NAD plus and NADP plus have a special role in the trapping and transferring of electrons and hydrogen ions in cell activities. Let's have a closer look at this so that we can understand it a little bit more. NADP plus takes part in photosynthesis. Remember the P here. NADP plus can pick up two electrons and a proton or a H plus, and it is converted into NADPH. NADP plus is a low energy molecule. NADPH is a high energy molecule. Now the reverse can happen as well. The NADPH can lose two electrons and lose a proton and will be converted into NADP plus, which is what you had in the beginning. Again, this interconvertibility, where the two chemicals can be converted from one form to another, is vitally important to understand in photosynthesis. We have the same scenario in respiration. The NAD plus, which takes part in respiration, is able to pick up two electrons and a proton and be converted into NADH, which is a high energy molecule. And the high energy molecule, NADH, can lose two electrons and a proton and be converted into NAD+. This sounds rather complicated. We're particularly interested in NADP+, because we're interested in learning about photosynthesis. NADP+ is a low energy molecule. I like to think of NADP plus as being a taxi, NADP's taxi service. It's involved in photosynthesis because of the letter P. NAD plus is a taxi service, NADP's first cousin, involved in respiration. NADP's taxi, NADP plus, can pick up passengers. He can pick up two electrons and a proton. It then becomes NADPH, hired. NADP's taxi is hired. It has the H, which is the proton here, H for hired, and it has the two electrons. It will then deliver the two electrons and the H plus from place to place, dropping them off wherever they are needed. When it is carrying its three passengers, the two electrons and the H plus, the two electrons in the back and the H plus in the front, it's full. It has energy. Again, the crack is mighty. There's energy in the taxi. NADPH is a high energy molecule. When NADPH, NADP's taxi hired, has the passengers, drops off its passengers wherever they are needed in the cell, like dropping a crowd off to the airport where they need to go. It's like something is missing too. The energy is lost as well. So when the two electrons and the H plus are dropped off, we now have NADP plus. The taxi isn't hired anymore. No letter H on it. It's a low energy molecule. It's empty. It's now free to pick up more passengers, pick up two more electrons and a H plus, and become hired or NADPH again. Now, for those of you who like the detail, we have NADP plus, which is a low energy molecule, picking up two electrons and a H plus, becoming the high energy NADPH. It will be the same with NAD plus, which takes part in respiration that we're not really too interested in today. Now, taking this step by step, we can see how it works out. NADP plus has a positive charge. When it picks up one electron that has a negative charge, a positive and a negative cancel each other out, and we create a molecule called NADP, which is neutral. This neutral NADP picks up one electron, another one, the second one, which has a negative charge, and then it will become NADP minus with a charge. That then will pick up the proton or the hydrogen ion that has a positive charge. The positive and the negative will cancel each other out, and hence we will create NADPH. From a chemical point of view, some of you might be interested in knowing that the addition of electrons to a molecule, that process, the addition of electrons, is called reduction. So therefore, we can say that the NADP plus, which you start out with, because it picks up electrons, is reduced to NADPH. As an added detail, the addition of hydrogen is also called reduction in chemistry. Now, the same caper is to be observed when we want to talk about NAD plus. We could go down through the same steps. More added detail. What is the role of NAD plus and NADP plus? Well, in photosynthesis, we have NADPH with the two electrons and a proton. It will drop those electrons off and the proton off, and these will be used to form glucose, which we will accept as a fact at the moment. In respiration, NADH, no P, notice, will use its two electrons and the proton to form what we call ATP, which we will just accept at face value at the moment. So in a nutshell, as we've already said, NAD plus and NADP plus have a special role in the trapping and transferring of electrons and hydrogen ions in cell activities.